The Army's a broadsword, not a scalpel. Trust me, Senator, you do not want the Army in an American city. 12 hours after the President gives the order, we can be on the ground. One light infantry division of 10,700 men. Elements of the Rapid Deployment Force, Special Forces, Delta, APCs, helicopters, tanks, and of course the ubiquitous M16A1 assault rifle. A humble enough weapon until you see it in the hands of a man outside your local bowling alley or 7-Eleven. It will be noisy, it will be scary, and it will not be mistaken for a VFW parade.
I remind you, General Devereaux does not speak for official Army policy.
Make no mistake. We will hunt down the enemy, we will find the enemy, and we will kill the enemy. No card-carrying member of the ACLU is more dead set against it than I am. Which is why I urge you. I implore you. Do not consider this as an option.
Morning. Today, with the invocation of the War Powers Act by the President, I am declaring a state of martial law in this city. To the best of our knowledge, we are opposed by no more than 20 of the enemy. He's hiding among a population of roughly 2 million. Intelligence tells us that he is most likely Arab-speaking, between the age of 14 and 30, narrowing the target to 15,000 suspects. We can further reduce that number down to those that have been in this country less than 6 months. Now you have 20 hiding among 2,000. If you are one of these 20 young men, you can hide among a population of similar ethnic background. Unfortunately for you, you can only hide there. And that population in the classic immigration pattern is concentrated right here in Brooklyn. We intend to seal off this borough. Then we intend to squeeze it. This is the land of opportunity, gentlemen. The opportunity to turn yourselves in. After sundown tonight, any young man fitting the profile I described who has not cooperated will be arrested and detained. There's historically nothing more corrosive to the morale of a population than policing its own citizens. But the enemy would be sadly mistaken if they were to doubt our resolve. They are now face to face with the most fearsome military machine in the history of man. And I intend to use it and be back on base in time for the playoffs.
The time has come for one man to suffer in order to save hundreds of lives.
Bates. I am the law. Right here, right now, I am the law.
You have the right
to
remain
silent,
General.
Order your men to lower their weapons, Agent.
You have the right to a...
Do you think that I would hesitate to kill you or every other federal agent in this room if I thought it was in the best interest of my country?